applications operating at high ambient temperatures, such as wireless base stations and military communications equipment, may not have adequate heat sinking or airflow and must derate the DC to DC converter to support the power demand of high-performance FPGAs and ASICs. A high-current DC to DC converter with good thermal performance will certainly solve this problem. We are using the TPS546D24A evaluation module configured to 550 kHz and single-phase operation with a 12-volt input, 1-volt output, and a 40-amp load. Since the converter has a serial PM bus interface with telemetry, we can monitor the temperature and current in real time through the GUI, which is downloadable on the web. Here we will monitor in real time a converter's thermal performance in a heat chamber set to 85 degrees ambient. Let's put the board in the oven and watch the temperature of the oven and the circuit board rise to 85 degrees Celsius. The converter is switching with no load applied, generating only a few degrees. Once 85 degrees Celsius is reached, a 40-amp load is applied and the temperature of the IC continues to rise, then level off. The GUI shows the converter rise to 113 degrees Celsius with an ambient temperature of 85 degrees Celsius, which yields a 28-degree rise. Since the maximum junction temperature of the TPS546D24A is 150 degrees Celsius, 37 degrees of headroom is available for heat generated by the converter, making the device perfect for thermally demanding high-current applications. To help designers better quantify the device's thermal capability, a safe operating area graph is shown in the datasheet under several output voltage conditions. If your application is thermally constrained, the TPS546D24A, with its small package size and low thermal resistance, will let you design a thermally optimal solution with plenty of temperature headroom. Pin-compatible 20-amp and 10-amp versions are also available and can be combined to share current up to 160 amps. Visit the link shown here for more information. Thank you for watching.